Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss the radiology findings in COVID-19 patients. Mostly we will be discussing the CT scan findings and few X-ray findings corroborating with the CT scan. So the indications of CT scan in COVID-19 patients, patients should be having dyspnea on visit, room air saturation less than 95%, any pre-existing lung disease like COPD, interstitial lung disease or any other risk factors. Elevated inflammatory markers like serum ferritin, LDH, D-dimer or CRP. So this is the flowchart showing how to go for a CT scan in COVID-19 patients. Suppose a patient is having moderate to severe patients. If it is COVID positive, we monitor the worsening of respiratory status. If it is stable, we may not do. If it worsens, we may do one CT scan. Suppose COVID is negative, however we have suspicion of having patient having COVID-19. Suppose the COVID-19 is negative test, we are suspicious of the patient suffering from COVID-19, we may go for a CT scan. In mild or absent symptoms, if it is COVID positive, again we wait for progression. If it is COVID negative, we may not go for a CT scan. If there is worsening, then we may go for a CT scan. So what are the typical features of pulmonary involvement in COVID-19 patients? Ground glass opacities with or without consolidations is an obligatory feature. Generally, they are found close to visceral pleura surfaces, including the fissures. Confirmatory patterns are ground glass regions, crazy paving, reticular pattern, halocyne, inverse halocyne, consolidation with airborne program. We'll see in ahead. The initial CT patterns in COVID-19 patients, ground glass opacification 88%, bilateral involvement 88%, posterior distribution 80%, multilobar involvement 79%, peripheral distribution 76%, consolidation only 32%. So this is a bar graph showing the positivity of a patient of the RT-PCR positivity with relation to your CT chest findings. Right now everybody will be well aware of the CORAD scoring, CORAD 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 being more likely and 1 being least likely. So we see that in CORAD 1 patients, only 6% turned out to be RT-PCR positive. However, in CORAD 5, 93% turned out to be RT-PCR positive. The yellow region showing that although they were COVID negative, however, their CT findings corroborated with your COVID-19 pneumonia. So the CORAD scoring, cumulative coronavirus disease reporting and data system. CORAD 0 is non-interpretable, scan is insufficient. And 6 is RT-PCR positive, irrespective of your CT scan findings. Now the CORAD scoring shows the likelihood of patient having COVID-19 pneumonia rather than severity. A patient may be completely normal on room air, however with a CORAD 5, when very mild subpleural posterobasal involvement is present, it will be CORAD 5, but severity score will be very very low. Patient can have a very high severity, CT severity score, and be symptomatic even with a lower score. Maybe because of any other disease or even if COVID-19 pneumonia, it may not be a typical feature, can be CORAD 3 and 4. So we see CORADs 1, there is no lung involvement, completely normal. CORADs 2, we can see near the cardiac image, cardiac shadow, there are few ground glass opacities on the right side. CORADs 3, those are peripheral ground glass opacities again on the right side. CORADs 4, it is peripherally present. It is nearly subpleural in the posterobasal part. CORADs 5, multilobar involvement, bilateral involvement, again ground glass opacities. So it is very highly likely of COVID-19 pneumonia. Now coming to severity, this is based on the number of lobes involved. This is the European system, 5 points for each lobe, 3 for the right, 2 for the left. So if 5% of a lobe is infected, it is score 1. So as the score percentage of involvement increases, scoring increases. So the calculation is the sum total of involvement of all the lobes. So if the score is less than 8, it is mild. 9 to 15 is moderate, more than 15 is severe. So this is a CT from apex to the base of the lungs showing multilobular involvement with a CT involvement score of 11. There is another American score which is a 40 point system. Instead of the lobes of the right and left lung, it takes into consideration the bronchopulmonary segments. 18 segments in total, however they have divided into 20 regions. The posterior apical of left upper lobe was divided to apical and posterior, And the anteromedial basal segment was of the left lower lung was differentiated into anterior and basal. So 0% involvement was a score of 0, less than 50% was 1, greater than 50% was 2. So total 20 regions, maximum score of 40 points. The typical findings of COVID-19 pneumonia is multifocal groundless opacities, peripheral and basal distribution, vascular thickening, crazy waving pattern, reverse halo sign, spider wave pattern. Atypical findings being central or peribronchovascular, more apical distribution, lymphadenopathy. And very atypical presentation being cavitation, calcification, tree in bud, nodular, pleural thickening. So coming to the various findings in CT scan that we get to see in COVID-19 patients. So first we'll discuss about the ground glass opacities, septal thickening and the reticular pattern. So ground glass means a translucent ground glass appearance as a ground glass is seen. It is not a complete transparent glass which we can see through and through. Okay, this is an example how a ground glass is seen. Here in the CT we can see there are multiple spared regions completely black. Those are your normal lung tissue which are completely black. Now this portion which are interspersed with white granular densities, black and white granular densities, it is translucent, look like a translucent glass. This is your ground glass opacities. Now what is the cause of this ground glass opacities? Partial filling of air spaces, intralobular interstitial thickening, partial collapse of alveoli, preserved bronchial and vascular markings. In these, the lung volumes are generally preserved. So this is in a COVID-19 pneumonia. We can see the black portion is the completely normal lung. These are the white portions, not completely dense. See, these are the vessels that we see here in center, white, completely white. Those are dense white. Your consultation will be seen that way. However, these are what? Translucent, semi-translucent, black and white interspersed. Granular densities are present. This is your ground glass opacities. These are the HRCT pattern of interstitial lung disease. We see ground glass density in bilateral lobes. Okay, not completely opaque. What we see in the right side of image is total solidification with AR bronchogram. Okay, these are your consolidation, complete consolidation. And we can see there are some in the left side upper part. There are some ground glass opacities adjacent to your consolidation. This is the difference between ground glass density and consolidation. So this is an X-ray and CT scan taken 1 hour apart. You see the X-ray is completely clear, normal. However, we can see ground glass opacities in your right basal lobe. This is another example of ground glass opacities. Here we can see linear ground glass opacities along present along a line. Okay. Some consolidation, and here we see in the right side image B, pure ground glass opacities, bilateral involvement. So this is again another CT image at initial examination showing small patchy shadows in peripheral regions of both the lungs. Okay, left and right there are ground glass opacities, nodular opacities, ground glass. Okay, the same patient CT taken after 5 days, they have coalesced to form involve larger areas, multilobar involvement and increased density. This is more towards consolidation, and you see new ground glass opacities developed in the left side upper part, although it is the lower lobe but on the upper part of the image. This is CT finding of another patient, different level of lung starting from base, apex to the base, bilateral subpleural band like areas of ground glass opacities, which is very much likelihood of viral pneumonia. Now coming to the pulmonary interstitium, the interstitial tissue network supporting lung is peribronchovascular along the bronchus, then it is centrilobular, intralobular, interlobular, subpleural. This is another example, multiple consolidation area with interlobular septal thickening. The arrows showing the interlobular septal thickening seen on both sides of the lungs. We will see one enlarged image. This is interlobular septal thickening. The orange arrow showing the septal thickening. So on the left side we see a COVID-19 pneumonia and the right side we see a SARS 2003 CT scan. Both show ground glass opacities, bilateral lung involvement, very typical of viral pneumonia. Another example of ground glass opacities, okay, the black arrow, solid black arrow showing a lingular consolidation on the left side. Okay, the white arrow showing bronchiectatic changes and the broken arrow showing ground glass opacities in both hemithoraxes. So this is the X-ray and CT comparison of a same patient at the same stage. Left one we can see diffuse reticular alteration. In middle we see peripheral groundless opacities. On the right side we see dense involvement, extensive consolidations. Another CT showing groundless opacities with vascular enhancement, another variant. So those white arrows showing your vascular involvement, dilated vessels. This again showing the same dilated vessels. So the X-ray showing progression of the disease on the day of presentation, day 6 and day 8. Okay. So in the B we see groundless opacities mildly developed. However, it is much different from the CT scan, very very clear on CT scan. And here on day 8 we see septal thickening with persistence of groundless opacities. Now coming to halocyn and reverse halocyn. So nodular opacities and diffuse consolidations in both the lungs with central and peripheral distribution surrounded by a groundless halo which gives a halocyn. Okay, so here we see in this image there are central consolidations, dark white, surrounding that there is groundless opacities. So that is your halocyn. Okay, see in both all the four images there is a central consolidation solid surrounded by groundless opacities. This is your halocyn. Then there is a reversed halocyn. Here what we see, a focus of groundless opacity is surrounded by a crescent or ring of denser consolidation, also known as atoll sign. These are the various sections of lung showing diffuse groundless opacities in both lungs and also some consolidation is present. Here we can see your reversed halocyn, very prominent. Then again nodular consolidation surrounded by groundless opacities, a halocyn, and blue one showing reverse halocyn. Another finding, crazy paving pattern. So this is how a crazy paving looks like. Like on a footpath, many tiles of irregular shape are put together. So similarly, that is why it is called crazy paving. We can see similar findings in your CT scan. These are your crazy paving sign. This image shows very nicely crazy paving pattern. Air bronchogram seen in multiple groundless opacity lesions on A. The consolidation part, dense white is consolidation, and others are the slightly hazy part is your groundless opacities. Very prominent in B, image B, groundless opacities with crazy paving pattern. Another patient with crazy paving pattern, COVID-19 pneumonia, multilobar infiltrates. Widespread groundless opacities with focal areas of sparing and prominent septal lines. This is your crazy paving pattern. Coming to linear opacities and fibrous streaks. So multiple linear shadows seen in bilateral lungs, HRCT reveals linear opacities more clearly than standard CT. They are predominantly distributed peripherally, as you can see in the CT images. There are also nodular opacities present in the image B. However, on the right side of the lung in image A, B and C, you can see linear opacities. These are fibrous streak lesions in image A and image C in the peripheral regions of both the lower lungs. Consolidation and tree inward. Now coming to consolidation. Consolidation is a dense opacification as we saw earlier with air bronchogram must be present. So here we can see multiple consolidation areas in both the lungs, dilated bronchi, okay, within the consolidation, that is air bronchogram. Here again we see consolidation in bilateral with very thin rim of parapneumonic effusion. Coming to tree inward, this is how a tree inward appearance looks like. The CT shows very clearly tree inward. Another few CTs showing tree inward appearance, the arrows, very classic example of tree inward appearance. The middle and right images are very little difficult to know. Here I am showing, that is why it is easily appreciable, though not typical, but the first image is clearly typical of tree inward appearance. Now coming to atypical presentations. This patient presented with diarrhea and left iliac fossa pain. She had no respiratory symptoms, myalgia, loss of taste or smell or any fatigue. So it was suspected to be a diverticulitis. However, CT abdomen was normal. According to the hospital principles, a screening CT chest was done, which showed multifocal bilateral groundless opacities and crazy paving pattern. It was a CORADS 5. On testing, it was found that she had increased CRP, increased D-dimers and increased LDH with normal leukocyte count and no lymphocytopenia. So this was suspicious as a COVID-19 pneumonia. On testing, she came out to be RT-PCR positive. So this is another atypical presentation. Here we see segmental and subsegmental vessels enlargement, multi-lobe ground glass opacities, mainly parenchymal involvement. As we discussed earlier, it should be generally peripheral, but here we see central parenchymal involvement, which is an atypical finding. So this is an 82-year-old man with fever for 3 days before admission. The first CT showed, you see, on the right side, right chest, very thin ground glass opacity is present in the subpleural area. One day after, the follow-up CT showed enlarged lesions as well as air bronchogram sign. You can see the prominent bronchus, air bronchus within the ground glass opacities. 6 days after, the lesions increased, okay, more like a consolidation, and new ground glass opacities were found on the left side of the chest. We could also see the crazy paving pattern. Now image D, 12 days after treatment, follow-up CT show that the opacification has reduced. So this is the resolving of the disease. And the left side lesions, the nodal lesions, they have coalesced and formed a linear pattern. Okay, that is lamellar fusion showing a pleura parallel sign. The CT changes of another patient, we see multifocal ground glass opacities and consolidation is also present with vascular enlargement. Coming to progression of the disease, actually the CT progression over time. Early stages 0 to 4 days, you may generally find either no changes, no findings, or very small areas of ground glass opacities, partial crazy paving, lower number of lobes involved. During the progressive stage of 5 to 8 days, we see extension of ground glass opacities. It has increased, maybe more lobes are involved, crazy paving has increased than the previous. In the peak stage, 10 to 13 days, what we see is dense consolidations, pneumonia with air bronchogram. Then absorption stage, after 14 days, there is gradual resolution. There may be fibrous stripes present. As I had showed you earlier, fibrous streaks, the lungs recover and there will be fibrous streaks present. So this is your early stage, single or multiple scattered patchy ground glass opacities, mostly in the peripheral or subpleural area. Crazy paving pattern may be there, septal thickening reticular pattern may be there. This is your advanced stage, increased extent, increased density, bilateral parenchyma, more lobes are involved. The severe stage, completely dense consolidation, air bronchogram is present, pneumonia is present. This is your resolving phase. You see, those are again linear streaks or the fibrous streaks are present. This is the X-ray showing progression of the disease. Day 0, day 4, day 7, we can see that there is some right lower lobe consolidation in day 0. In day 4, there is perihilar consolidation has appeared. In day 7, that has improved. But still your ground glass opacities are somehow present. So this is the CT scan showing again the progression. Day 0, we can see there is some ground glass opacities on the left side. Day 3, it has increased, the area of involvement has increased and the new ground glass opacity has developed on the right periphery, the red arrow. So this is another progression of disease. We can see in the right side, day 3, ground glass opacities. Day 7, it has increased, the density has also increased. It is pneumonia now, consolidation is present, air bronchogram is present. Then day 14, there is still progression. Day 18, we can see, in the day 14, we see linear opacities. Day 18, your fibrous streaks have started presenting. And day 25, complete fibrous streaks. Interesting thing was, day 16, RT-PCR was negative, however, day 20, RT-PCR was positive. So RT-PCR positive, as we know, is because of your virus particles, maybe dead also. But the CT scan shows lungs recovering. This is another example, a small patch of ground glass opacity under pleura in the left lobe, very small one. In image B, day 9, it has increased, reticular pattern has set in. In image C, we see right side has also been involved now. In D, there is resolving of the changes. Left side A, C, E images are on day 13 of illness. Okay, we see there is ground glass opacities along with consolidation. Then in day 19, B, D, F, we see there is resolving of these lesions and there is fibrous tricks. Okay, so the take home messages for you: the typical appearance of COVID-19 pneumonia, ground glass opacities, typically with a peripheral and subpleural distribution, involvement of multiple lobes, particularly the lower lobes. Areas of ground glass opacities may be admixed with areas of focal consolidation with your air bronchogram pattern, and superimposed intralobular reticulations, crazy paving pattern. Linear consolidations and signs suggesting organizing pneumonia, such as the reverse halo sign, ground glass opacities surrounded by peripheral consolidation, very frequently found several days after the onset of disease. Now the atypical presentation being single lobe, unilateral, isolated lobe, discrete reinbird, cavitation, effusion, non-peripheral distribution. So when to do a CT scan? Generally 5 to 7 days after onset of symptoms. Then we will be expecting some good involvement of lungs with ground glass opacities present. Day 0 to 4 there are chances you may still miss out. So the patterns, because of the alveolar disease that gives us ground glass opacities. If it is interstitial disease, it gives septal thickening, crazy paving and others. Can CT become normal if the patient has recovered from the illness? Not necessarily. Some patients may have a normal CT after day 14 or day 18 or day 20, like 2 to 3 weeks. However, it may take 6 to 8 weeks for the radiological resolution. Patient may be completely normal after 2 to 3 weeks of your disease, but there will be fibrous tracts and some ground glassing present, which may take 6 to 8 weeks to resolve. Do all patients with lung involvement develop post-infective lung fibrosis or progression of lung lesions? No. As in normal ARDS, normal human ARDS, very few number of patients progress into a fibrosis. Rest, they resolve normally. So can we predict the nature or progression of illness with CT chest? It is still a question. We feel that we can know the progression of disease if a serial CT is done, like increase of ground glass opacities, increased area of involvement, then you're changing into consolidation and gradually resorption, the density changes, it reduces, then it develops fibrous tricks. We can know the progress of disease. Though a single CT at point of time, single CT may not be able to predict it properly. However, there is no point in doing serial CTs if there is clinical improvement. We do a CT scan only when the patient worsens. Can we predict the cytokine storm with CT chest? No, not at all. Is CT thorax is a game changer? Not necessarily it's a game changer, but if RT-PCR is negative and patients have symptoms very highly suspicious of COVID, you may go for a CT thorax. Basically, it is multimodal approach to diagnose a COVID-19 pneumonia. Which CT, HRCT or CECT? This is a very good question. HRCT is very sensitive to catch our changes, CT changes, means to our lung changes in cases of COVID pneumonia. Some may argue for CECT as most of the complications that we have known are because of your thrombus, microthrombus. Okay, so should we go for a CECT? The problem is that the microthrombi that causes the various complications in these cases of COVID-19 pneumonia, they are generally present distal to third order divisions of pulmonary artery. Okay, so these are very difficult to catch by CECT. So it should be HRCT first. If there is hemodynamic instability, sudden deterioration of saturation, then you may suspect a pulmonary embolism or you may go for a CECT. So correlate with your D-dimer levels and you may start anticoagulants. Thank you.